Hey guys, welcome back to Last Humans Garage. We finally got a nice substantial mod in the house for the Forester XTI. First, I've been mentioning a bit, wasn't 100% feeling the stripe, and I like the way the vinyl looks so good. I guess I'll have to be a copycat like everyone else, and I plan to vinyl the last bit of chrome. As you remember, I did do my fog bezel is black a couple days ago. But let's get to the fun stuff. I did get the brake upgrade, as you probably told by the subject of the video. So let me get a good camera angle here set up, and I'll show you what I got. Now first, you remember I did the whole DBA upgrade on the WRX. Disc Brake Australia, sponsored by K&S Brakes. I love these brakes, no BS, I love them. I wouldn't change anything about them. I'm 100% finished with the brakes on the WRX, they're so perfect. So although there were a few different options for the Forester, including Brembos and stuff, that's kind of the opposite of the deal with the Forester. I want to go lighter on the car, not heavier like the WRX, a little bit milder. So I really wanted to reproduce the exact same feeling and quality that I got from the DBA kit that I put. So I almost got all the same stuff. The thing is, the rear rotors on the Forester change between 14 and 15 up with the EyeSight option. Most people don't know this. Main dealers and sellers don't know this. K&S Brakes knows this. It's their specialty. He's the number one specialist in brakes. So go to K&S and talk to Ken if you really want the true story. But sites like Rally Sport Direct, for example, advertise the rear WRX rotor I put on this fitting all Forester, like 08 and up or something like that. It does not fit when you get to 15 and up. So that's a misrepresentation on the site, a mistake maybe, a little overlooked. But Ken has assured me that that is not correct information because he works directly with DBA. He's their main supplier. So he has all the inside deals on it. All right, all that being said, let's check out what we got. Get you a good angle here. All right, that's good enough. First, we again went. Now, apparently the pads are the same, just the rotors are not. So we start out with the SP500 line of pads by DBA Brakes. Now, I don't know if it's front or back, whatever it is. So I have front and back pads, exactly the same line that went on my WRX. I should mention, also, this was not a sponsored part. I paid for these. I did get a nice little discount on them, but I paid for more than half of these myself. Just so it stand out there. You can't really ask for, you know, a double sponsorship on the same part. It's just not really right, you know? So me and Ken worked out a deal we were both happy with on this. Disc Brake Australia, my favorite part now. So as you might have guessed, I'm not doing rear rotors right now. And probably never will, to be honest. Let's take a look at the T3 Club Spec 4000 series with the kangaroo paw vent for better airflow through the rotor itself, the triple slots for a quieter grip and bite, and less dust also because of the triple slot. These are so heavy that they're busting through the circles, but they do look all right. Someone was probably tossing these around. It's a 45 pound box, which is ridiculous. Ugh. But I'm sure they're fine. Let's get some of this out of here. Oh man, is that sealed? All right, I'll just bust it open. Let's take a look at it. Ugh. Oh, dang, those are big. What kind of angle do I got on that? Let me get this straight. Ugh. Look at that. Woo! Again, these are the club specs, so they do have the heat markings. Not that I ever need them, but it's kind of cool. And the kangaroo paw, which is not straight through vents like common cheap rotors, they're offset to create more turbulence inside and more airflow. You have the improved alloy metal when you step up to the T3 series as opposed to the T2 series. And of course, the black hats are always standard. And the triple slot that I mentioned, the T2 only has two slot sets. The T3 has three slot sets, making for quieter braking and better clearance of dust. Really awesome. These brakes are insane. Let me just inspect the other one to make sure that it's okay. Ah, these things are literally breaking my back. Like 22 pounds of rotor. All right. Go there. This will be the weekend's installation, by the way. All right, just make sure this one's all right. All right. Yes. Super heavy. It's killing my arm, even if you don't believe it. There's our color marks. Beautiful, beautiful. Right there. These rotors are excellent. I'm wondering, I can't hold this up. I'm wondering, because the Forester rotors look so big already, I'm wondering if these are any bigger in size at all, or if they're exactly the same size and they're just better in, you know, performance and design. It'll be interesting to find out this weekend. So there you go. Big thanks to Ken at K&S Brakes for hooking me up with a little package deal on the DBAs again to do on the Forester XT. I love these brakes. I've had StopTechs, I've had Hawks, I've had every mainstream brand, and I've never liked a brake set like I like these. So give K&S Brakes a visit if you want. Contact Ken through his support, and I'm sure he can work something out for you, get some good deals going for you. And I look forward to this installation pretty soon. All right, guys, stay tuned.